Welcome to the Butterfly Effect, brought to you by Moss Adams. I'm Chris Horner. This is stage 12 of the Tour de France 2021. 160 kilometers, 100 miles in length, and normally this is looking for a field sprint and marks Cavendish to Kuna Quickstep team to be able to tie the legend Eddie Merckx on Tour de France stage win. When the racing starts at kilometer zero, Bora Hansgrohe are on the front throwing down attacks. That's right, it's Bora Hansgrohe. Let me back it up. Before the race started, Peter Sagan announced he's out. He's got a sore knee. It flared up on him from the crash at stage three, and then he bumped it again two stages ago going into the sprint. He hit it on the handlebar, and he's dropped out. Now, why did I bring that up? Okay, the first attack, Bora Hansgrohe is the one attacking and their teammates. So keep that in mind. Once you lose a sprinter on a sprint stage, that is a team that would normally help control a stage like today, and so they could be there to help Mark Cavendish, the Kuna Quickstep, control a stage like today. Instead, the Kuna Quickstep now will lose Bora Hansgrohe, and not only do they lose him, it's a double swing, right? It's like when you miss a three-pointer in basketball and the guy goes back and scores 3 points. It's a six-point swing, not a three-point swing. It's the same in cycling. Now Bora Hansgrohe, instead of helping to control for sprints, now they're attacking and making it more complicated for sprinters to be able to win today's stage. Now right away, after the Bora Hansgrohe rider attacks, it's split. The field is blown up in pieces and echelon all over the place. And we're 2, 3, 4 kilometers into the stage and the race is blown up. We're seeing guys like Geraint Thomas going out the back, Thomas DeHaene, the legendary breakaway specialist that should normally be perfect on a stage like that, going out the back, and the wind is blowing hard. So quality guys going out the back. At one point in time early in today's stage, we're talking 10 kilometers or so into it, there's 70 guys left at the front. Everybody else is out the back in echelon. Now, Mark Cavendish looks fantastic. He's at the front in perfect position, has a few Dacuna Quickstep riders with him, but he's got Dacuna Quickstep riders off the back. So up front, 20 kilometers to go, a group of 13 split off and strong group of 13. Dacuna Quickstep put Julian Alaphilippe in this move. Inside the move, Archaic Samsic. That's a sprinter team. We're talking about Nasir Bahani's sprinter team now represented in the break. Luka Mezic, bike exchange rider, is represented in the break. That's Michael Matthews' team, sprinter Michael Matthews' team, represented in the break. And I already told you Julian Alaphilippe was up there. That's three sprint teams that normally would control today's stage now represented in a break of 13 along with Dacuna Quickstep. The only sprinter team that missed it, really, Alpecin Phoenix. And so back in the group of the field, they're all sitting up and going wide while 13 guys are going up the road. Now, in my book, this was crazy. I don't know what Dacuna Quickstep were thinking. I mean, you're putting Julian Alaphilippe in there. Now, everybody at home's like, Chris, it's Julian Alaphilippe. He can win anything. As I told you on the Butterfly Effect before, when stages come down in altitude and up in flatness, the riders become more fair and more even. In that break of 13, there are some quality guys. We're talking about Stefan Kuhn, Stefan Bissinger, both Swiss riders and both strong classic guys. Niels Paulet is up there. We've all seen him in Paris-Roubaix, get second at Paris-Roubaix. He loves the flat courses. He's a big guy with a lot of power. Lotto Soudal have not one, but two guys up there. Movistar are represented with Erviti Emmanuel. Fabulous, strong rider, and especially when we're talking about smaller climbs, flat roads, and a little bit of crosswinds. These guys are all on level playing field with Julian Alaphilippe for sure. So I know when you look at it, Julian Alaphilippe is the star, right? But when you bring the altitude down and the flatness up, they start becoming even. And in my book, Niels Paulet on the flat roads, riders like him, Sweeney, the Lotto rider, having a teammate, Brent Van Moore. We saw Brent Van Moore in Dauphiné solo the finish up rolling climbs, so we know he's on fabulous form. And this year at the Tour de France, we saw him hold off the peloton all the way until Mark Cavendish passed him on stage four. So a lot of strong guys in there. When you're telling me you're Dacuna Quickstep and you had a chance to win this stage with Mark Cavendish, but instead you're willing to play Julian Alaphilippe in a group of 13. You're breaking my number one rule. And we guys, you all know the number one rule. You don't leave your leader. And if you're the leader, you don't leave your guys. Okay. Mark Cavendish, sprint leader. Julian Alaphilippe, if it was a smaller group and he had teammates, I would have loved this move. Had it been 13 guys and Julian Alaphilippe had one teammate with him, I would have liked this move. There's a bit of a roller of a climb with about 15 kilometers to go. If Julian Alaphilippe had one teammate to help control all of the attacks at the end of today's stage, I wouldn't have minded had they played it if there's two Dacuna Quickstep. But 13 guys going up the road and one Julian Alaphilippe, there's not a whole lot anybody can do against 12 riders. Break goes up the road, gains massive time. We're talking about 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 16 minutes they'll have on the field behind. So you know Julian Alaphilippe has no help from behind. 50 kilometers to go, just at the mark that you would expect. The attacks start coming, and it's Niels Paulet throwing in the first attack with 50 kilometers to go. It'll take about 15 kilometers until finally a group of four will break away from the group of 13 back there. Four guys up front, all power. Sweeney, Stefan Kuhn, Irvetti from Movistar, and Niels Paulet. They're all on fire and form, and they're going away behind their organized back there. But you got to remember, there's a lot of Soudal rider Brent Van Moore, whose teammate Sweeney's up front in the group of four, and he's going to sit on. The guys in the back are working, but you have sprinter Andre Greipel back there. So nobody wants to pull Andre Greipel to the finish. Up front, the group of four are inching out time on the group of nine before, but they're working well together. When they hit the final bump in today's stage, it comes about 15 kilometers from the line. There it's Sweeney that throws in the first attack, and that sends the Frances de Jure rider, Stefan Kuhn, out the back. Sweeney's got a gap, but Niels Paulet and Irvetti will do work together and pull Sweeney back. Before the top, Niels Paulet's going solo, and he's looking fabulous. The two riders behind are trying, but they're not bringing him in as Niels Paulet's gaining time all the way to the line to win stage 12 of the Tour de France. Now, let me back it all the way up again, back to the Peter Sagan interview. Okay, when Peter Sagan gave that interview, you knew Bora Hansgrohe were going to be on the tack. If Peter Sagan had stayed in the race, Niels Paulet would not even have had the opportunity to go for today's stage win, because he probably would have been on the front working for a field sprint for Peter Sagan, or driving it on one of those bumps on today's stage to try to get rid of Mark Cavendish. So when you look at today's stage and you break it down, Niels Paulet has, I think, maybe one important win throughout his career. He's second at Paris-Roubaix, like I told you, so he's got great results. He's always up there amongst the classic guys when we're talking about Flanders and Roubaix. But to win a stage at the Tour de France, this is just absolutely fantastic day for Niels Paulet, because he doesn't get these kind of opportunities. So when they come, you have to take them. This was normally not one of them, but Sagan not taking part in today's race allows Niels Paulet to take a great win in his career. Fabulous day for Bora Hansgrohe. Again, losing a rider like Peter Sagan at the beginning and then winning at the end of the stage. The director in the car, fabulous moment and sensations. Much like yesterday's stage where Tony Martin crashed, Jonas Vingegaard's up there with the favorites on GC, and Wout Van Aert's winning the stage. The emotions of sports are just absolutely fantastic, and that's why we like to watch. It was a great stage when you break it down tactically, and I love this kind of stage on the butterfly effect, because it gives me so much to talk about. Today's stage, Mark Cavendish had four flat stages in order to tie Eddy Merckx or possibly take the lead, and they gave this stage away. Now you gotta ask yourself, it was hard at the beginning, so maybe Dacuna Quickstep possibly couldn't have controlled the stage. But remember, we're talking about Dacuna Quickstep. A stage like today is what this team is built for, okay? It's windy, it's crosswinds, it's only 100 miles in length, 160 kilometers. And this was, in my mind, a stage that they threw away that Mark Cavendish could have added to the tally of his Tour de France stage wins. When the field finally comes through today's stage, Mark Cavendish walks past guys to steal more points on the green jersey. He flew past Phillipson like he wasn't even trying. Phillipson looked over at his teammate because Mark Cavendish came by so fast, gave a look to his right shoulder, and I bet he was thinking, why did we even try? Mark Cavendish beat me hands down, no problem. In my book, crazy tactics on today's stage from De Kuenick Quickstep, Julian Alaphilippe being in the mix in that group of 13 looks like it's a chance for a win. But when you're a group of 13 and you don't have any teammates with you, you've broken the number one rule on the butterfly effect, so I'm not going to agree with that tactic. You got to believe the other 12 guys all know who Julian Alaphilippe are, because we surely do. And so there's no way they're ever going to go to the line with a character like Alaphilippe. His chances of winning today's stage are not that good when you really break down the quality of guys he was with today. Like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys very soon on the Butterfly Effect.